A question that I get asked often is, how do you define your style? And I always feel a little bit anxious about answering that question because it's such a weird question. For any individual person, it's going to be different. And I always get a little bit stuck on, how did I find my style? What is my style exactly? I started to understand a little bit better what my style is when I started to think about the different ways that I create and the through line through all of those different things. Between writing, filmmaking, photography, there's always a similar element to everything that I make. That being the creepy factor, the cinematic factor, and I started to hone in on what my style was. But the fact is this, you can define your style all you want, and that's great, and you should be able to if you're going to be a professional at your craft. But it's not about defining your style as much as it is connecting with how you came to that style in the first place. Style is nothing more than curiosity, in my opinion. Style is what comes out of us when we explore our curiosity, when we follow what excites us, when we dive into what interests us. Then we start to cultivate a sense of seeing, a sense of creating. And it's that sensibility that we have when we first start out in everything that we do that becomes our style, and particularly our signature style. When I started creating images, I never once said, you know what, I want to create images that look dark, creepy, and painterly. That was not at all what I did. I got my camera, a tripod, and I made what was in my imagination, what was already inside of me, without thought of what it would look like. And that's what came out. The exciting thing about this is that anyone can do it. Literally anyone can try to figure out what your style is by creating what feels natural to you. So you might say, well, lots of things feel natural to me. Okay, so who says you can't have lots of styles? We get so caught up in what we're supposed to be doing that we don't let ourselves explore our curiosity. Our art is the culmination of who we are, emotionally, physically, how we react, how we see the world. The more we know ourselves, the more we can figure out our style. I'm near the end of editing this image, and I thought it would be really handy to go backwards in the edit and peel away what I've done to find the steps that hint at my signature style. What choices have I made to create an image that feels like one of my images? One of the first things that I did when I started creating was I decided that I didn't like the standard photographic ratio, that 2-to-3 ratio that you often see in images, because I didn't really like photography that much. So I wanted people to see something else, whether that was something that looked more painterly or otherwise, I didn't care. And square was just how I saw the world most naturally. I pursued that, and ever since then I've been creating square images to get rid of the photographic ratio. So you see a square image here, as in every single image in my entire portfolio. If we start to peel back the layers, you're going to notice a lot of texture here. And this is the first step that feels like a signature style to me. Lots of people use texture. I know that lots of people use texture, so it's not fair to say that any one thing that I've done has created a style, but it builds on itself, and it's the textures that I use and the way that I use them and how I blend them that create something unique. I don't believe that you can choose any technique and then say that's your signature, because techniques can be copied. What can't be copied is the way, the sensibility in which you use them, and where that desire comes from within you. The way that I use this particular texture is on soft light. So I had this texture set to normal. This has a layer mask on it, so it's already been erased a lot, which is why this isn't looking at full opacity. But once I erased it where I didn't want it, I've changed it to blending mode soft light. This color that you see coming on and off is the first curve that really takes the color into the realm that I particularly like. So if I click into that curve, you can see what it looks like here. The RGB curve has not been touched, so this is just for color. And if I click into RGB, you can see that the red curve has been taken in sort of opposite directions, where the shadow right here, where this area here, which is the shadow portion of the curve, has been taken down into the cyan region of the curve, so that the color cyan is inserting itself into the shadows, whereas red on the opposite end of the spectrum is being put into the highlights. So we have an opposite color curve here. And then if we go to blue, you can see the exact same thing. Lots of yellow added to the highlights and blue added to the shadows. And just to see what that's done again, it's sort of softened the image a little bit. It's taken away that natural blue light that comes from the sun and replaced it with almost an evening glow. Oddly enough, these changes right here are really big for me and my style. And it might not seem like it because this is fairly insignificant as far as changes to this image go, but what I've done here is I've dulled down the light in the background, and that automatically brings the eye back to my subject. Doing that, any sort of combination of what this is doing, bringing the focus to the subject and not on the background, is what I spend a lot of my time doing with selections and curves in my edits. This is another example of that, this particular curve here, in which I am brightening my subject and right through the center of the frame, right through here. I've added in some clouds, and that's what you see here. And something that I really like to do in my work is to create mimicked shapes. So here I have this circular figure, and then up in the sky, I have that same sort of shape, that circular shape where the clouds are really condensed here. And you even have almost what looks like little tiny people happening in the clouds, just little lumps. But I really like to mimic those shapes, so this cloud choice was very particular for me. If we go down to the very beginning of this edit, I can show you exactly what I've done. So you can see how this image started as just one figure in the water, and it has been added to by adding many more figures, a hole in the middle, sky in the upper portion, and the frame has been expanded as well. There are some keywords that I would use for my particular style. They would be square format, painterly, surreal, dark, textured, feminine, and cinematic. But there could be more, or maybe I'm wrong and there are actually less. What really matters is that when I look at my images and I've gotten to the end of an edit, it feels right. It feels finished. It feels like mine. And as long as I can keep creating and an image feels like it's my image, then I've done my job because I'm happy. Thank you very much for watching. It would mean so much to me if you would subscribe or share this with your friends or family or whoever you think could benefit from seeing a little bit of the editing room, talking about style or anything else that you see on this channel. It really brings me great joy to make these videos and I'm so grateful that you're along for the ride. So thank you so much and I can't wait to see how your style evolves too.